Once upon a time, in the Australian outback, there lived three little wallabies and a big bad dingo. Now, a wallaby is a cuddly little cousin to the kangaroo, tender and sweet and delicious to eat if you happen to be a dingo. A dingo is the Australian canine equivalent of the big bad wolf. One day, the three little wallabies decided it was time to leave the cozy confines of their mum's marsupial pouch. It was getting a bit chock-a-block in there, so they would take the leap and build new homes of their very own. First out was Adelaide, a sweet, lovable, but quite lazy little wallaby that everyone called Addie. Next out was Sydney, a big friendly bloke and a bit of a slacker as well, called Sid. Last but not least out of the pouch, the third little wallaby was Brisbane, a very hard-working and reliable little chap whom everyone called Brisbane. The three little wallabies, with tears in their eyes and adventure in their hearts, said goodbye to their wallaby mum, who gave them each a kiss on the cheek, a Vegemite sandwich for their long walk about, and this bit of motherly advice.
Goodbye, me dearies, and remember, build your home safe, sturdy, and strong. One never knows when the big bad dingo might come howling at your door.
The three little wallabies promised to follow their mum's instructions, said goodbye one last time, and hopped away into the outback. Before long, just down the road, they came to a nice dry weedy patch of blowfly grass.
"Bonza," said Addie, "this blowfly grass is spot on perfect for building my new house."
"Not sturdy enough," said Brisbane.
"Oh, rubbish," said the very lazy little wallaby, who began building her home as the others continued on their way.
Addie's grass house was polished off in a jiffy. It might have looked like a dog's lunch to you and me, but she was apples as far as Addie was concerned. Meanwhile, Sydney and Brisbane kept on hopping, and just down the road, they came to a scribbly gum tree, with the bark on its trunk marked up like newsprint in the local rag.
"By jingoes," said Sid, "the sticks from this scribbly gum tree will make me a fine home, fair dinkum."
"Not sturdy enough," said Brisbane.
"Oh, bite your bum, Brisbane. Let me have a go," said the rather lazy little wallaby, who began building his home as Brisbane journeyed on, all alone.
Sid's house built of sticks was finished in an hour's time from go to woe. The construction may have been a bit dodgy, but Sidney thought his new place was a bobby dazzler. Now, after a while, just down the road, the third little wallaby, Brisbane, came to a billabong, where there was a great deposit of tan-coloured clay dirt above the water. Brisbane was a plodder. He worked hard all day shaping the clay into bricks, and all of the next day baking the bricks in the sun. And the day after, he built a fine brick home as solid as Ayers Rock, the largest granite rock in all the land down under, and all the world. It was lots of hard work indeed, but when the yakka was complete, Brisbane's new house was ridgy-didge, safe, sturdy, and strong, just as his mum had said it should be. Now the three little wallabies could enjoy life on their own. They were quite chuffed with their new homes. Until one day, when a big bad dingo named Derek came prowling about. First he came to Addie's grass house and knocked on the door.
Little wallaby, let me come in."
Addie was frightened and answered,
"Not by the hair on my chinny chin chin."
"Then I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll blow your house in, I will,"
said Derek, the big bad dingo, and he blew an enormous gust of wind that destroyed poor Addie's grass house in the blink of a rabbit's eye. Addie hopped away as fast as she could to her brother Sid's house, with Derek the big bad dingo close behind. Derek soon came knocking on Sid's door.
Little wallaby, little wallaby, let me come in.
Sid was frightened and answered, not by the air on my chinny chin chin.
Then I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll blow your house in, I will, said Derek the big bad dingo as again he blew an enormous gust of wind that sent Sid's stick house tumbling down like so many pickup sticks.
Addie and Sid barely escaped with their lives as they went racing off to their brother Brisbane's sturdy brick home, with Derek the dingo in hot pursuit. Soon Derek came knocking on Brisbane's door.
Little wallaby, little wallaby, let me come in.
Not by the air on my chinny chin chin, said Brisbane.
Then I'll huff, and I'll puff, and I'll blow your house in, I will, said Derek,
and a nasty blast of dingo's breath hit Brisbane's sturdy brick home full on, but it didn't budge a brick. The three little wallabies looked out the window laughing like kookaburras at the dingo outside.
Right, he said. Now I'm cheesed off. I'm fed up to the back teeth with you little wallabies. I'll teach you lot to make fun of a big bad dingo like me.
And again, he huffed and he puffed and he blew as hard as he could. But Brisbane's brick home remained standing, tall and proud. The three little wallabies laughed themselves silly while Derek tried to catch his breath.
Oh, I'm puffed. All right, mate, you win. I'll pull up stumps, said Derek as he went skulking away. But I'll be back, mind you. I will be back. And no more mucking around next time.
The three little wallabies watched with glee as Derek the big bad dingo hoofed it away. But all was not well, for Derek had a dastardly scheme. A short time later, Derek came sneaking around, on tippity toe this time, and stealthily climbed up onto the roof of Brisbane's fine brick home. He quietly made his way across the clay tiles to the chimney, where he meant to lower himself into the living room and then gobble up the three little wallabies for a nice midday meal. But the wallabies predicted that Derek might attempt this plan and built a blazing hot fire in the fireplace. When Derek got to the chimney, he smelled smoke and saw the hot fire blazing below. The three little wallabies started up laughing and called from inside the house.
What's the matter, Derek? Too hot for ya?
All right, Mr. Big Bad Dingo. Don't go and chuck a wobbly on us.
Come right in, mate. We were expecting you.
Right, said Derek. And I was flaming expecting something like this. Nothing a bit of Adam's ale can't fix.
And Derek the big bad dingo took out a bucket of water and poured it right down the chimney so that the fire went out with a hiss. Then down the chimney he came like a big bad dingo Santa Claus. And in an instant, Derek the big bad dingo was inside Brisbane's house, leaping out of the fireplace and coming at the three little wallabies with his fangs bared and claws outstretched.
Well, 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 me happy little Vegemites. Looks like you lot are cactus now. Time for Derek the big bad dingo to boil his billy.
Sorry to lob in, me dearies. It's me, your mum, and I brought someone to meet you. What's all the kerfuffle about?
Brisbane quickly opened the door and in hopped the wallaby's mum, along with the tallest kangaroo any of them had ever seen.
I love the new place, me dearies. Look who's come for a visit. It's your cousin, Kenneth the Kangaroo from Canberra.
Kenneth stood at least 6 feet tall, with a massive tail as thick as a tree trunk and big, powerful legs rippling with muscle.
Right, I was just leaving, said Derek, the big bad dingo.
But before he could make his way out the door, Kenneth stopped him.
Not so fast, mate. Have you been making trouble for my little cousins? Actually, you see, I'd just come round to give me new cobbers a proper welcome. But apparently there's been some sort of a mix-up. I'll just shoot on through.
Right, that's what I thought, said Kenneth. And with his sturdy kangaroo hind legs, which can really pack a wallop, he knocked all the ivories right out of Derek's mouth.
Who wants a Vegemite Sanger? Said the wallaby's mom. I brought enough for everyone.
And so they all sat down together for tea, the three little wallabies and their wallaby mum, Cousin Kenneth, the kangaroo from Canberra, and Derek, the now toothless dingo, who did indeed become friends with the three little wallabies and even assisted in the reconstruction of their new brick homes, and who, by necessity, developed a keen appetite for Vegemite sandwiches.